Here's a problem that came up on the Math 091 midterm review. A boat can go 35 miles per hour in still water. It takes as long to go 160 miles upstream as it does to go downstream 240 miles. The question is, how fast is the current? So we'll let x be the unknown, which is the speed of the current. And we're going to have to set up two equations, and we're going to use the equation distance equals rate times time. So with the current is the same as going downstream. So our distance downstream would be 240 miles, must be equal to the rate. Now we know the rate of the boat is 35 miles per hour, but in this case, it's going with the current. The speed of the current is going to make it go faster, so the rate is 35 plus x. We don't know the time, but the time for these two situations is the same. We'll let t equal time. So going against the current, it's going to be 160 miles. Now, since the boat is going against the current, the speed will be slower, so it'll be 35 minus x times t. Now, these two t's are the same. So if we take a look at our distance equals rate times time formula, if we solve this for t by dividing both sides by r, we would have t equal to distance divided by rate. Now, the reason we want to use this is because we know that these two t's are the same. So if these two t's are the same, the two distances divided by the rates must be the same. So in this case, going with the current, distance divided by rate would be 240 divided by 35 plus x must equal. The second distance divided by rate would be 160 divided by 35 minus x. Again, the reason we can set these equal to each other is because if we call this t1 and this t2, they're equal. Therefore, the ratio of distance and rate must be equal. So to solve this, we can perform cross products. So we'd have 240 times 35 minus x must equal 160 times 35 plus x. We'll go ahead and distribute here and solve for x. If we distribute 240, we're going to have 8,400 minus 240x is equal to 5,600 plus 160x. Let's add 240x to both sides. That would give us 400x on the right. And then we'll subtract 5,600 on both sides. That will give us 2,800. Dividing by 400. We have x equal to 7, or 7 miles per hour would be the rate of the current. I hope that helps.